Hello, my creative peeps, and welcome back to my channel for another video. Today, we are doing the January 2020 Take 5 prompts. I'm so excited to be here with you. Happy New Year's Eve or New Year, depending on when you're watching this. New Year's is my favorite holiday, right next to Halloween, of course. So, I wanted to do the Take 5 a little differently today. So I'm going to talk a little bit and then we're going to get right into the journaling. I'm going to speed it up with a voiceover and we'll talk about the prompts and stuff like that. But I wanted to talk about where I'm kind of headspace I am today. Today we are the 22nd of December as I'm filming this and I'm trying to give myself a few days off. So I have a lot going on in my brain, and because of Christmas festivities, I won't be able to get into my office. And I was putting off creating this video because I didn't feel like creating an entire page. I just wanted to play around in my journals. I wanted to catch up on all the stuff I have sitting on my desk that I wanted to put in there, and I just wanted to get creative. I was kind of telling myself I couldn't do that because I need to do a spread or project dedicated to the Take 5 Challenge. The point of the Take 5 Challenge is not to put any rules on you, right? It's to get you out of your comfort zone and to get you thinking out of the box and trying new things. So today I thought I would take you through a journal session with me, what one typically looks like. This will look a lot like my Creative Week videos, and these are the types of videos that you see on Patreon as my Journal With Me's on Sundays. So if you are on Patreon, this will be nothing new to you. But if you aren't, this is what a typical journal session looks like for me. I'm gonna bounce around between lots of different pages and we're gonna see what we can create. I'm going to make it a point to do all of the prompts during this journal session, but they're by no means gonna be on the same page or in the same spread. So I won't have a finished product to show you after this, but I hope that this video relaxes you, gives you some good ideas, helps you kind of get geared up for journaling in 2020. And yeah, if you'd like some extra inspiration, of course, all of the ladies from the Take 5 Challenge that I do this collaboration with are linked below, so you can check out their take on the prompts. And without further ado, let's start journaling. Surprise! I bet you did not expect to see my face. I thought we could do a little face-to-face voiceover, so we'll just get right into it since I've already blabbed for so long. The prompts this month were chosen by Amira, and they were modeled after the Christmas song, on the first day of Christmas, blah, 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 gave to me or something, I don't know. but anyway, it's 5 strips of paper, 4 stamps, 3 colors, 2 images, and 1 word. So kind of a countdown to the new year, even though it already is the new year. So I just started by opening up my journal. This is my Christmas December journal that I'm still working on. I previously had taken a bunch of the Daphne's diary craft things out of the magazines. I can't get my foot over. Okay. And one of the exercises in one of my old magazines was to make these bows. So I made the bows and then I was like, what am I going to do with all these random bows? So I turned them into paper clips. So that was me turning one of them into paper clips. I just have my thing here. So if I'm looking at that and not you, that's why. Here I have all of my prompts that I've been using for December daily. So I'm just going through them and seeing what ones I have left to journal. I know that's not the part of the Take 5 prompts, but this is just how I started. And I remember my Patreon peep, or our creative peep Jennifer, had sent me some tags. And I need tags with one of the prompts. So I pulled out one of the tag stickers that she sent and put it on just a random page. And then I'm taking some of the packaging from stuff she sent, and it said stickers, and I don't know why, but I just wanted to put it in my journal. I'm obsessed with stickers, that's no secret. And I just really liked the font of it. So we stuck that in there at the top. If you're ever looking for good sticky tape, check out my Amazon storefront, because the best double-sided tape at the best price ever is there. I swear by it. Next, I'm just taking some sticker flakes that she had also sent and kind of jazzing this page up. And then pretty soon I'll actually start using the Take 5 prompts. This here is a pocket that she made me years ago, actually. It was in the first mail she ever sent me, and I hadn't used it yet. I was saving it, so I decided this would be the time to use it. This here is my 2020 journal that I'm working in, so you guys get a little peek at that. More on that will be coming in the next couple of weeks. I will show you my 2020 setup. So I just added a little bit of washi tape there, and I'm gonna make a tip-in. This tip-in was a little tricky to make because the textured, like, shiny paper didn't want any tape to stick to it. So I used some heavy-duty, like, packing washi tape. A packing washi tape to stick down there, and then I just decorated it with the washi I used on the other side. Excuse me. It would not be a Leanne voiceover without yawn. So, just making some more washi collage there. And then I'm starting on my first prompt. So, one of the prompts is two images. So, I'm using one of the vinyl stickers from my shop. This is the Moon vinyl sticker. It's there right now. And I wanted to use this vinyl sticker on all of my... all of my 2020 stuff. So I have that, and then I have this piece of paper, which is also one of the things. So one piece of paper from my scrap bin with these moons on it. Oh, that tip-in wasn't sticking, so I had to use a piece of double-sided tape to keep the washi tape down. And then I was trying to figure out where I wanted to stick that. I was pretty sure I wanted to stick it on the side. Originally, my idea was to make like a stamped collage image with my mantra for the year, which you'll see me do later, but I don't do it on this piece of paper. I do it on a different piece of paper. So that's why I'm looking through the stamps. I already had kind of an idea of the stamps I wanted to use for it. But again, I decided against doing it on that piece of paper. Here I'm using this Fabri-Tac glue to stick this down. I hadn't tried Fabri-Tac before, so I purchased some at Michael's. And if you have a problem with smells, do not... by this glue. It smells like acetone, which I already knew, but I had bought it to try out with my journal making, and to be honest, I think I'm going to stick with Alien's tacky glue, because it works just as well. It may dry a little slower, but honestly, it's like, at least you can get Alien's tacky glue on your skin and not have to worry about it. And I make a huge mess when I craft, so I'll be using that up, but it's not my favorite. Next, we're doing my second image for the Take 5 things. I'm using another vinyl sticker from my shop, and it's the pizza. I'm taking these scrap, it's basically an envelope that I have my scrap in, and I'm cutting it apart and using it. I'm going to use this label stamp with my archival ink. The archival ink's also in my Amazon shop because it's like the only ink I use. I love it. So, stamps. That would be one of my stamps. I have no idea where I got this label stamp. I got it on clearance somewhere. It still has the clearance sticker on it, as you can see, so I'm sorry I can't link it, but anyway, I'm just using that. I never use my stamps. Like, this is probably maybe the second time this year that I've used them. That's an exaggeration, but I definitely have not used my stamps more than 10 times this year, for sure. So I was really happy to have this prompt to push me out of my comfort zone and get me to use them more, because I do really like the ones that I do have. And I'm just sticking that label down on this piece of paper. I used some alcohol markers on the other side so it bled through, and it just makes a cool background. So I'm putting the label on there, and then I'm gonna add my pizza sticker. All of my vinyl stickers are also available in like regular sticker form. So if you did want some of those in regular images, that is available over on my Etsy shop, which is linked in the description box below. Next, I'm using my Christmas numbers, which was a printable in the shop this year. I don't know why I put a 20 there. I was looking in my bullet journal and I don't think anything of note happened on the 20th. I also didn't make pizza for dinner. I made stir fry for dinner. So I don't know why that went down there, but a 20 apparently. So next I'm taking the label I stamped out and I'm using this stamp set. This stamp set is from Heidi Swap. It's been discontinued for a long time. If you guys have followed Allie Brown, you may know that when she originally started, she was using this stamp set and everybody and their mother's brother wanted it. And a couple years after that, I just found it randomly in, I think, Hobby Lobby, and I grabbed it. But now she like has her own that she released in a similar font or something. But I like the Heidi Swap one, and that's the one I have. So I stamped out 2020, and then I'm going to color it in. I'm going to take my colored pencils. I just got these colored pencils, and I had never heard of them before, but me and my aunt had saw them on Joggles, and I bought my aunt the large 36 set of all the colors for Christmas, and I picked up a few of the singles myself, and they are by Posca, which you guys know I love their paint pens. So I wanted to test them out. This is the first time using them in my journal. I did a test between the Uni Posca pencils, the Prismacolor Premier pencils, and then the Polychromos pencils. I only have a few of the Polychromos because I buy them singly, and obviously I only had a few of the Uni Posca, but I wanted to test how they blended, and honestly, the Uni Poscas are super bright. I don't know if you can see this, but these are the Uni Poscas. They're super bright. They're all relatively bright, though. The Polychromos was actually the least bright, which I thought was interesting. It also was the one that blended the worst. These blend amazing, the Uni Poscas. But if you already have Prismacolors, then they're not really worth it. I will leave the Uni Posca color pencils linked below. They don't have, like, they don't leave a texture when you touch them after, which is really cool. So, at least on the paper that I was using. So, again, I'll leave those linked below. They are super expensive, though, so it's kind of one of those things where you want to get it as a gift. And I did lose camera battery during this filming session, so this was a bit of a jump. I just stamped all those stars, that was all you missed, onto the 2020 and then onto a separate piece of paper, which I still have not used yet, actually. So here I'm just testing the different color combos that I want to use. I did 2020 in the color scheme that I did the Patreon downloads in for January, but I wanted to pick a color scheme for the 2019 that I'm gonna stamp out. So I just was testing out those there. Oh, my tea is cold. Thank goodness I got a coffee mug warmer for Christmas. Don't mind me. I'll be right back. Nothing interesting's happening. We're good. Loudest intermission ever. So here I am stamping out the 2019, or I'm done stamping out the 2019, and then I'm going to color it in. I really do enjoy using colored pencils. I really liked how these things, whatever. I really like how the dates came out when they were colored, and I really need to use my colored pencils more in my journals. And yeah, it was a favorite supply at the beginning of the year, and it's still a favorite supply. I've just like stopped using them as much, and I really wanted to get back to them because the colors are just gorgeous. Also, you may notice the lighting changes throughout this video because I filmed this over several hours and the sun sets at like 3. Like right now it's almost dark outside and it's 3:30. 3:45. Okay, well, you know. So next I stamped You Are Here for 2019. That has to do with the meaning of my tattoo that I have that says You Are Here. I felt that 2019 really embodied the meaning of that tattoo for me. I don't know if embodied is the right word, but that's how I felt about it. Anyway, moving on. You may also see the charging cord for my camera pop in and out of this shot. I do apologize for that one. I did not realize until I was editing the video, but hopefully my face right here is covering it up, so it won't be a big deal. And just sticking the dates on to my journal pages, I put 2020 on the last page of the journal and then 2019 on the previous page, and I hope to kind of write some sort of 2019 reflection on that page. We'll see. A lot of the times I do a bunch of things in my journal, I get to the end, and then I never write in them, they just go on the shelf. So hopefully we can change that in the future. But now I'm just looking through my stamps. I want to make that piece of paper that has my mantra for the year on it. Usually I do a word for the year, and that's traditionally what you do, or what most people do, but I decided to do a mantra this year because I just felt like I wanted more than just a word behind it. So on the top I'm stamping these mountains, and then I'm going to stamp, I'm going to stamp octopus tentacles. And then last, I'm going to stamp some planets and stuff, and you'll see how that all ties in with my mantra in a second. At this point, we've definitely used all the stamps we were supposed to use. I used 3 colors, so that was the colored pencils. I used 3 colors. Instead of word of the year is the prompt, so I'm doing my mantra of the year. And I've definitely used 5 pieces of paper by now, so that would be all of the Take 5 prompts at this point. So if you're only here for that, you can stop watching. Otherwise, we'll keep journaling. It wouldn't be a Leanne video without my phone going off a million times. So I'm just going to turn the sound off. So I'm just putting together a little collage of these different planet stamps. These stamps are by an independent company, so I can't link them for you because they don't exist anymore. It's just like one of those side designer companies, and it's just like a one-off and whatever. Also, you'll notice that I am quite the amateur stamper because I stamped those images using the side that's supposed to go on the acrylic block and not be stamped. Luckily, a wipe fixed all of that for me, but so there's that. Next, just stamping these stars all over. And yeah. Just cutting it out of that envelope because I did again stamp it on a scrap envelope, and then I was trying to see where I was going to put it and make sure it was going to fit and that I didn't need to trim it down before I wrote my mantra on it. So next I'm going to pull out my Posca paint pens because Posca paint pens are the best. And I'm pulling it out in three colors, and I'm going to take another scrap piece of paper and excuse me. I had a weird tickle in my throat. That was weird. Weird. Okay. I'm testing out the spacing and the placement that I want to use for my words, and I just wanted to make sure that the colors would look good together again. I'm using those three colors that I have chosen for the start of 2020. So my mantra is climb higher, swim deeper, and love harder. It means a lot of different things. I want to do more exploring, so climbing and exploring are kind of the same things. So, reminds me to get outside, I want to enjoy my summer, so swim deeper, but also, I just, in my general, like, life, I want to continue what I'm doing, but go harder, like, go deeper into what I'm doing, give more, be more passionate, like, just dig deeper and climb higher, and love harder, so... like a cheesy, I don't know. It's hard to explain, but I know what it means, and that's all that matters. So I wrote with the Posca paint pens. I had to do a couple coats with the pink one, and now that I'm looking at it, I may go over it with my colored pencils to make it a little brighter. But there's that. I also put some black shadowing on the climb since it wasn't all on the black like the higher was, and I thought it looked funny. So I'm just paper clipping that in there because I'm not quite sure where I want to put it yet, but there's that. And I'm checking off, making sure I did all of the prompts, and I did. So there's that. All the notifications. That was my iPad. So unprofessional. Okay, so now I'm going to back to my prompt list for my December prompts. I'm working off of several prompt lists. I'm working off of the Use Your Junkmas 2019 prompt list that was hosted by Taylor and another lady on Instagram. Taylor is Little Creative Life. And then I'm using a bunch of the prompts that Courtney, Little Raven Inc. put together for her patrons. So I basically cut all of them up and filled the pages. I also printed out the Create December prompts. I don't think I ended up doing any of them. I'll have to look, but I'm not really doing the prompts on purpose. I'm just kind of checking off the ones I did by accident. I don't know. So one of the prompts was gift wrap, and I had this wrapping paper that Jennifer had wrapped the box she sent me in. It was a mouthful. And I'm just using that to create a pocket. Of course, double-sided tape. And I'm still not quite sure what's going in that pocket, but the pocket's there. And then I'm using some of those cutouts that I had, again, from a Daphne's Diary magazine that I was playing with. And I just really liked this. I thought the pun was funny. It takes two to mango. and I love mangoes. So I'm just putting that on the pocket there. Then I'm looking through some of the other things Jennifer sent me, and she sent me these cool like resin epoxy stickers, and they're clear but like galaxy over other things. So I put this wolf there, and just because it looks cool. And then she sent me these awesome like skeleton anatomy type stickers, so I just chose one to put up there. That holographic paper that's already on the page was also from her package that she had wrapped it in. It was like sticky already on the back. I don't know how to explain it, but it was really cool. So I did that, checking off more prompts. I got these tags on clearance at Michael's, so I'm using one of those coffee cup tags, and I knew I wanted to use this gingerbread man-eater stamp. I use this every year. I love it so much. I just think it's so funny. So I'm using a piece of ribbon that came with my December daily journal that I got from Jillian. And I'm just cutting little slits in there to make like the ribbon ends. And then I'm gonna stamp again the gingerbread with Man Eater on there. I'm just realizing they have some New Year's stamps on there, so I should probably pull that out and use that before it's too late again. And I'm really not that great of a stamper, and this really isn't a good surface to stamp on. So I did stamp with my archival ink, and then I went in with my Posca fine tip black paint pen and went over where I had inked it just to make it look better. And it worked out perfectly because it was basically the same width as the stamp. I believe these are from Kelly Perky. Again, it's one of those like independent stamp things, and I'm pretty sure Kelly Perky announced that she's shutting down her store in the next couple months, so I'm sorry that I can't direct you to those. I just colored him in with a colored pencil, and I'm just gonna paperclip him onto a page. Then I decided to use another one of those bows because I still have so many on my desk. So I'm just going to grab my glue and glue a paperclip again to the back of it. I should have glued something on top of the paperclip so it didn't look so ugly, but I was not kind of, that didn't click at the moment. I can always do it after, but that's one of the things I need to do. And then I'm using this. This is a free printable on emeraldwinterwood.com. This is Elizabeth's shop. Elizabeth is a creative and Patreon peep. And yeah, so I'll leave her linked below if I can remember. If I forget, please let me know so I can do that. But it's just like a printout, so I'm using that. And it's like a Christmassy postcard, but I really liked this butterfly on there, so I'm just going to add it as a tip in. And if you guys have trouble with tip-ins, you can, I have a class on tip-ins in my Etsy shop as well as on Skillshare, so you can either go purchase it on Etsy, or if you aren't a member of Skillshare, you can get 2 months free and take my class using the link in the description box. Now I'm going to do a wax seal. This is one of the prompts on Use Your Junkness, and the lovely Beck from Australia, one of my longtime creative peeps, she sent me a bunch of goodies, and this wax seal was in there, and it has an L on it, and I don't have one with an L, so that was really exciting. So I'm just using one of my wax seal stick things and making a seal. It's another one of those supplies that I love a lot, but I never think to pull out, is my wax seal. So I feel like I need to try and remember to do that more often. So there's that bow. We're just putting that on there, and I believe we're finally done. Thank you guys so much for hanging out with me today. I'm just gonna flip through. Thank you to all of the ladies who do the Take 5 collaboration with me. I'm so excited to be doing another year. Next month is my prompts. That's really exciting. Thank you to Amira for choosing these. If you'd like to see what all the other ladies did for their Take 5 challenges, you can check out the links in the description box and use the hashtag Take5Art when you post on social media so that we can see what you made. I love seeing what you made. If you post your photo, go ahead and tag me so I can check it out. There's also video playlists over on Kyra's page for each month, so you can click on that and you can see not only our videos of the ladies who host it, but also videos that you guys have submitted that you have videoed yourself making art with the prompts. Those are really fun to watch. Thank you so much to my patrons for sponsoring today's video. They make the content that I do possible, and we have lots of fun over there. If you liked today's journal with me, then you'll love what I post over there. It's more real time, it's not sped up, but these are the kind of journaling sessions that I usually have all over the place and just doing a bunch of things. It's a lot of fun. So again, thank you guys so much for being here. Happy New Year. Happy 2020. I hope you have a fantastic kickoff to the start of the year. And I will see you guys next time. Take care, guys.